Street, you see this first photo here, you see a black bag there along the street, and then you see afterwards at virtually the same location, the explosion. You see these bags. WHDH says they provided these pictures to the FBI as they continue their investigation. They're looking at the pictures to see if it's possible it could be the second bomb. In the first picture, they say you can see a bag next to a mailbox and up against a barricade along the Marathon route. In the second, which they blurred because it's very, very graphic, there is no sign of the bag. That from our affiliate WHDH, the FBI now investigating these photos to see if, in fact, that is the bag that contained the bomb with the pressure cooker device. Fran, let me bring you back in. Assess what WHDH is now showing.
Well, what will happen is the FBI in particular and the forensics lab at Quantico will take these photographs, the fragments that have been sent to Quantico, and this is the painstaking process. When the chief of police in Boston says this will be methodical and they will be cautious, this is the sort of painstaking investigative steps. They'll try to measure up fragments, small fragments of what's left, to what they see in these photographs, and try to see what they can learn in particular about the construction of these specific devices. They'll then try to see what they can learn about the device that's not pictured from the other bomb site in Boston. They'll look for things like fingerprints, DNA samples. You may find DNA samples of victims, Wolf, but you may also find DNA samples, hair and skin samples from the bomb maker himself. And so those are the sorts of details that they will begin to try and get from the crime scene, the forensics, and photographs such as these.